Thanks for joining me this morning. I wanted to do a little bit of breathing, a little bit of isometric stretching, a little bit of isometric exercise. The key to all of this, you guys, is really maintaining your breathing. You want to pull from your diaphragm. You want to expand your chest. You want to get your chest cavity as big as possible. Your lungs are like two balloons. The bigger the cavity they can expand to, the bigger the expansion you'll get. Body science. Check it out. Pull up. Once you get to that top of the breath, hold your body in that position. Keep your chest really big and wide. Hold it for as long as you can, and then slowly exhale. Trying to keep your chest as big as it was when it was full. Really engaging your core muscles, really using your diaphragm to pull everything together. And then when you get to the bottom, you hold and you push. Another interesting little bioscience fact, you bring in oxygen through your nose because your sinus cavity is larger than your oral cavity. So you can actually breathe in more air at a slower pace, keeping it cooler. Also, this is where all the filtration happens. It takes all the dust, all the stuff in the air, traps it in there so you don't put that in your lungs. Breathe in through the nose. No matter how big that breath is, you can't hold it, because your body is taking the oxygen out, putting it into your circulatory system, moving that all around your body, and replacing it with CO2 gas. CO2, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, one of the monoxides. You saw me taking some hits, you know. But the replenishment rate is larger. So you're going to have more CO2 exhale than you had oxygen inhale. So you're going to breathe all the way to the bottom of your breath, big lungs. As you're breathing out, your body's still producing carbon dioxide. So when you get to the bottom, you're going to hold, produce a little bit more, exhale that too. Hope it helped. Spread love.